friends, welcome in our English online class. Today we are going to start a new topic in English course book, and that is a poem, The Bees, written by the poetess Vivian Fox. Now students, here the title is The Bees. Bees means when something disturb you, when someone disturb you. Okay, so we use the word bees. You are teasing me, you are disturbing me, you are irritating me. So here the bees means something which disturbs you, someone who disturbs you. So here the wind is disturbing the poetess. That's why here the poetess is saying the bees. Here the bees means the wind which is disturbing the poetess. Students, here the wind has been personified by the poetess Lillian Holmes. What is personification, students? Do you know? Personification is a literary term which we use in the poems. And personification is when we give human qualities or characteristics to non-living things, to the animals, to someone's idea, to express their feelings. That time we are using the personification in the poems. Okay, personification is a literary term which we use in the poems. Okay, here I have written some examples. The first one, I ventured lonely as a cloud. This is a famous line of a poem written by William Wordsworth. Now here the poet has been personified the cloud. The cloud cannot express its feeling, but here the poet is expressing the feeling of cloud with the help of personification term. One more example we have. Two sunflowers moved in the yellow room. This is a poem written by William Blake. Okay, here the sunflower has been personified by the poet. Okay, students, to express the feeling of sunflower. So when we use the human qualities to express the feeling of non-living things or animals, that time we are using personification. Okay, now students, come to the poem The Bees, written by William Holmes. Here today we will do only the first stanza of the poem. Okay, so first of all we will have a look with of the lines of the stanza. You are all useless, I declare. You tease me so, it isn't fair. You pounce on me from everywhere and seize my head and clutch my hair and tie my clothes in knots and tear the leaves and blossom from the pear. So here, student, here the word you. Who is you here? The wind. The poet is telling to the wind that you are disturbing me, you are teasing me, you are irritating me. So you are a nuisance. You are creating a trouble in front of me and you are creating a trouble in front of everyone. Then you start to blow, you trouble everyone. The nature, the human beings, the animals, they disturb because of you. I am declaring this thing that you are nuisance. You are creating trouble, you are annoying, you are creating a trouble in front of everyone. And this thing I am declaring. You tease me so. You are teasing me right now and you tease me. You tease me, you tease me. You tease the nature, you tease the animals. And this is not fair. This is not a good habit to disturbing others. You should leave this habit. You pounce on me from everywhere. Whenever you start to blow, you jump to hold each and everything. Okay, then you start to blow. You disturb my hairs, you disturb the clothes, you disturb the things, whatever we have. That is why you pounce on me from everywhere. The meaning of pounce, jump quickly in order to take hold of something and seize my head. I have a hat on my head, but when you start to blow, you hold my head, and sometimes it is not on my head. If when you start to blow, the hat will be on the ground and clutch my hair, and because of you, my hair disturbed. When you start to blow, I have have two, it is too difficult for me to manage my hairs. Okay, the hands are, the hairs are not in my proper manner. They disturb. Then I have to comb my hair just because the hairs are not in a proper manner. That's why I have to comb my hair there because of you only. And tie my clothes in knots. And when you start to blow, the clothes are, suppose the clothes are there in the garden, in the park, outside of the home, outside the home. So when the clothes are there outside the home, then and when you start to blow, then the clothes were not in a proper manner. They disturbed just because of you. So it looks that they are tied each other and they had a knot. It just looks as they are not in a proper manner. And tear the leaves, and then you start to blow the leaves. The trees shed their leaves. Okay, and the fruits also fell down and they are on the ground. And when does all this thing happen? When you start to blow, the leaves are on the ground, the fruits are also on the ground, the clothes tied, and the hairs not properly arranged, the hat, the clothes are not in a proper manner. And all these things happen just because of you when you start to blow. And that's why you disturb each and everyone. That is why you are a nuisance. Okay, students. So I hope the lines of the first stanza of this poem, that is clear to you. That's all in today's lesson. Have a nice day.